Healthy macaroni and cheese on the truck. I'll show you how. Hey y'all, let's have some comfort food on the truck. A lot of times we get in the mood for something comforty, but we're trying to eat keto and anti-inflammatory and not take in so much of the regular pastas and the comfort foods of the drive-thrus and things like that. So we have these gluten-free pastas from, we get these at Aldis, and they're gluten-free. They're made with the brown rice and the quinoa. They still have a lot of carbs, but it's the healthy carbs. It's the carbs that you can have that don't fluctuate your blood sugar. So we're gonna be using these today. Now, if you wanna use regular pasta, you can. Elbow macaroni, whatever you wanna use, but we're gonna use these. And these cook up a little faster than pasta, so you have to be careful, but we'll show you. And then we're gonna add butter. We use real butter. We don't use margarine or any of the artificial stuff. Full fats are better for your body. Again, your blood sugar, it's all about how your blood sugar, how all this reacts in your body to your blood sugar. That's why we do it. Heavy whipping cream, again, full fat. You want the full fats in your recipes, not, you know, the low fat thing was so big for so long and everybody's discovered that the healthy fats are good for you in portion sizes. You know, we're going to have some comfort food today, but we're not going to have, you know, a plate full of comfort food today. We're still going to portion control. And because this is what I've got on hand, we're going to use the extra sharp cheddar. We're going to throw a little mozzarella in there, and that's just because that's what we've got on hand. Whatever your favorites are in your macaroni cheese, go for it. You know, we use lots of different cheeses. So let's get this thing going. Okay, we are gonna get some water boiling here. We've got about 3 cups in this 12-inch skillet. We use this for everything. If you've watched our videos, you've seen this before. We use this for a lot of things. You can also use the Instapot that we have on board. But about 3 cups in here, about a tablespoon of butter. You need some kind of oil to, you know, slide that pasta around a little bit better. We're gonna use 2 cups. And we're gonna half the recipe because it's just the two of us. And again, we don't want a ton left over. So we will put the recipe below, and that way you guys can do the whole recipe or half it, or even we fourth recipes sometimes, just, you know, so it's not too much food. But anyway, we'll get the pasta going. So we got our water boiling in our 12-inch skillet. This is a skillet you've seen in many of our videos. We use it to cook with a lot out here. But you can boil pasta in it just like you can if you've got something on a cooktop. You can also use your Instapot to boil it up in there on Sauté if you've got an Instapot on board. But we chose a skillet today. But we're gonna put our pasta in. I've got about 3 cups of water in the skillet now with just about a tablespoon of butter. You just want your pasta floating good. Is the main thing. But we'll link a recipe below and let you know what we did. And we're halving the recipe. You can do it in full recipe. You can do it in a fourth of the recipe. Whatever works for you. So we'll get started. Okay guys, our pasta is done. We are just gonna take a slotted spoon. Just scoop that up out of there because we don't want to bring all this water into our dish. If you got room on your truck and you have a strainer, it's quick and easy too, but it's more cleanup. So we like to keep it as simple as we can, but we're just going to drain all this pasta off and then we'll move on to the next step. Okay, we drained that pasta. We've got the pasta all drained up. The water's gone. We poured it in a separate dish. This you gotta keep your eye on down here, this temperature, or it'll get a little too warm on you. But we wanted to melt that butter, so that's what we did. And I'll turn that down. It's getting a little hot. And then I wiped out the skillet. You don't have to do that, but it's okay if you want to start with this part of the recipe. So we're gonna melt this butter. We're gonna add the heavy whipping cream. And then we're gonna add another cup to that. The skillet's way too hot, so don't have your skillet as hot as we have our skillet. We're gonna add that second cup in there. Maybe we'll see if we need all that. So we're gonna add some cheese, and I'll put the measurements for you down in the recipe, but I'm just gonna do by, you know, eyeballing it now because I've did it so much. Oh, and something we forgot to mention are in the beginning of this video, we also do this with cauliflower instead of the pasta if you want it to be even lighter. So then you've got a vegetable, and so it's like macaroni and cheese, but it's made with cauliflower. And so we do that from time to time too. But for now, we're gonna do the pasta. We're gonna get the cheeses in there. We're gonna get those mixed up. We're gonna get the pasta mixed in. And it'll take us a minute here to melt this cheese. Okay, so we'll get that going and we'll be right back. Now we've got our cheese, our heavy whipping cream, and our butter all mixed up. So now we're just gonna add the pasta. It's gonna wanna stick to the plate because it's been sitting there for a few minutes. But we just wanna add that in there. Okay, set that aside. And you can see the starches on there, but again, this is the healthier way to eat your pastas, or again with the cauliflower is another good alternative if you don't want the carbs. But you just mix this all up together. I think my heat's turned off. Turn it back up just a little bit. Mix this all together. Now today we're just gonna serve it this way. When I have time, we're sitting still today while we're getting loaded. So we're doing this while we're getting our load. So when we have time, we love to just scoop that. Look at that cheese. Oh my gosh, I'm gonna need my spoon. You have to be very careful because this is a nonstick pan. Look at that. Oh my word. You know, we don't hold back on the cheese. We eat a lot of cheese, a whole lot of cheese. And, you know, because cheese is good for you. Cheese, again, is that healthy fat. I may have overdid it a little here. I threw in a little extra here, so I may have overdid it a little bit. But we love it. When we do have time, we do put it in the little baking dish like these. And, man, look, that's the mozzarella that's stretching that way. But we love to put it in the little ramekins or any kind of little baking dish and bake it up and brown in the oven. And then the butter really comes out even more, and it browns up real nicely. So, but anyway, that's some pretty good comfort food for the truck. And again, we'll put that recipe down below so you guys can see exactly what you need to do. But get out and cook something today. Hey, give this macaroni a try.